Welcome to my channel. Today I'll be explaining the difference between sum and sumx. Now if you're aware, sum and sumx both are really very important Dax functions that are used in Power BI. Okay, but what I find is, although there are a lot of videos or materials available in sum and sumx, but many of the people would actually find it difficult to distinguish between the both and what is the exact scenario, especially in case of sumx. Okay, so let me try my level best to go ahead and explain it with really easy examples. So first of all, I'll try to go to the sample finance file. So how I am going through it, I'll just tell you. So open Power BI desktop, right? So this is your Power BI desktop. Once you are inside Power BI desktop, all you need to do is go to get data, correct? And go to Excel workbook. Now, generally where it is going to be installed is, you have to go to your program files. From program files, you go to Microsoft Power BI desktop, and inside bin there will be a folder called sample data. Correct, sample data. Inside sample data, you will be finding the free financial sample data that comes with Power BI desktop. So all you have to do is click on open. Once you click on open, this file will get loaded and you will be able to see the financial data. Okay, now to make things simple, what I have done is I have loaded, and I have, just for the sake of the example, so that all of you guys won't get confused with a lot of columns, I have deleted some of the columns from the financial data, and these are the columns that I am keeping. Okay, so first of all, to understand sum, which is a very simple function actually, okay, what sum basically does is, there will be a numerical column, right? So let's say the numerical column is profit. So what is the dimension against which this sum of profit is being derived? Is it against country that I am getting sum of profit, or is it against product that I am getting sum of profit? That will depend when you come to your visualization pane. Okay, so I have already created some of the visuals, and let's see this. Okay, so it's a very simple profit that I am calculating using the profit column. I am doing a sum of profit, that's it, very simple, right? And this profit using sum, I am showing as the last column over here. What is sum? Now sum is actually a measure, and a measure comes with a particular amount of magic with it. Why am I calling it a magic? Now you know, most of the visualization tool, including Power BI, that visualization will depend on the dimension groups that you are actually pulling. So now you are pulling segment, country, product and discount band, right? So for a particular date, look, there is a date also. I have actually made the date as constant, right? So I am filtering only for October 1, 2013. So this is gone out of the picture. Now look at the grain of this data. When you pull segment, country, product and discount, automatically, and obviously date, it groups by this particular columns. That means that each and every row is now going to be unique. This is very important concept, right? So a combination of government, Germany, Amarilla, low for the date October 1, 2013 is only going to occur once in my data. Okay, and now what happens, look, now what happens, this entire data is being calculated grouped by these particular dates and the profit, this particular columns, and the profit using sum, this is my sumx column, right? Sorry, sum column that I have created. Look, sum of profit, right? Now look at this 246178 for Amarilla low, and there is another row for Amarilla medium which has 1912. Look very carefully what happens when I change the grain of the data. If I remove the discount band, what will happen? These two rows, low and medium, will get removed and it will get grouped by only segment, country and product, right? Let me show you what will happen. If I remove the discount band from here, look, that low and high gets removed and it is automatically grouped by segment, country and product. So in short, Amarilla occurs only once, right? And what happens to my profit? So if I do a control Z, look at the numbers very carefully. 246, right? 246178 plus 1912, it gets summed up. Okay, so both these rows get summed up and I get, now let me remove the discount band again, and I get a 248090, which is the sum of those two amounts for Amarilla. Correct? So this is the magic that occurs through, right, Dax measures rather. In this case, in our case, it is sum. What will happen if I remove product? This is a question to you. You might pause the video and try to answer yourself. Let's get to the answer now. If I remove product, what is happening? You are grouping by only by segment and your country. Correct? So there is only one occurrence of government and Germany, right? That means all these four rows will get merged. These values will get merged and you will get only 542855, which is the total of the entire four rows, right? What I mean to say is, let me now remove the product. I'm going to a different level of grain now, one level higher. Look, so you are getting 542855.90. Now let's go to a further complicated scenario, which is SUMX, right? Now, to understand SUMX, you have to understand the grain of the data, because again, what do I mean by the I always call it my base data. What is my base data? The data that is present in your data tab. This is your base data, right? So now if you look at your base data, you see the grain level again is at segment, country, product and discount band, because government, Germany, Amarilla, two rows are repeating, right? Look at the first two rows. What is not repeating? It's the discount band, low and medium. Correct? So, and for a particular date, obviously. So I can say that the level of my grain level of my base data is at 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 columns. These are defining the grain of the data. Now there are two columns, remember, unit sold and sale price. Correct? So these are the total units sold for Amarilla, and discount is low, 2966, and the sale price for each is 350. So if you multiply the total units sold with the sale price of each, what you will get? You will get a total sales. Now what I have done, for the sake of simplicity, I have created a calculated column over here, right? So let's look how I have created that calculated column. This is the symbol. Look at very carefully. This calculator symbol means it's a measure, and this symbol, which has a small summation size, this means, right, it's a calculated column. So how I have done this calculated column? I have just multiplied my sale price with my units sold. Now, why am I explaining this to you? Because I'll create the same thing over here. I'll create the total sales, but this time I'll use SUMX to calculate this instead of a calculated column. Okay, let's hit our visualization, right, and try to do this. So let me show this from the beginning. First of all, I'll follow the hierarchy, right? First is segment, then is country. After that, I have my product. After that, I have my date. Look at over here, it's in hierarchy, right? The date is in hierarchy. So what I'll do, I'll quickly convert. That's why you're getting year, quarter, month, and day. So what I'll do, I'll convert this hierarchy to a simple date using this technique. That's it. Now look. The dates are simple dates, Sunday, September 1, 2013, right? Fine. So I have already have my grain level set, segment, country, product, and date, right? Now, the two numerical columns that I need. So chip in, units sold, and I also need my sale price. Great. So I have everything ready. As I told you, I'll try to explain things simply. So for the sake of simplicity, just let us filter the segment by government and the country by Germany. Great. Let me go ahead and increase the size of the values. I'll go to values, next go to text. Great, I hope you're able to see this now. Great, so now almost we are ready. I'll create the DAX using a SUMX. Right click, go to measure. Again, this is also going to be measure, and as I explained in my previous example, measures are dynamic in nature, right? So now I'll say total cells using sum x. You give a shift enter, go to the next line, and you type in sum x. Give a bracket. See what Power BI suggests you. It says the first argument is a table, right? And the second argument is an expression. Now, let me give the table first. The table name is financials, right? So this is the table, comma. Next is an expression. Expression can be anything. Now, this is the difference between sum and sumx. Sum always accepts a single column as an argument. Over here, sumx, on the contrary, accepts an expression. The expression might be addition of two columns, multiplication of two columns, subtraction of two columns, maybe an expression, column A plus column B divided by column C into 2. Right, anything can be an expression. In our case, what do we want? What is our end goal? We want to achieve unit sold, correct? Unit sold multiplied by the sale price to give us the total sales, right? So I'll go to financials and I'll go to sale price. These are the two columns, column one multiplied by column two. This is my expression. Great. So now I'll hit on enter. Okay, it's asking me to rename it because I already have something using one. So I'll call this as SUMX1. Enter. Total sales using SUMX1. Okay, so I will quickly add this total sales using SUMX1 to my visual. It's just a simple click. And this is, observe very carefully what is happening. If you look at government for Germany, product being Amarilla, okay, look at lot of dates are being selected, okay. So I'll make my life easy. I'll only select October 1, 2013. Why? Because that's how I showed you the base data, remember? October 1, 2013. If you go to the base data, look, October 1, 2013 is selected, right? So I told you the grain, that let us select October 1, 2013 for the sake of simplicity. And the grain of the data is now based on segment, country, product, discount, band, right? And obviously date. Now look at Amarilla. The sale price is 350 and 7, right? If you go to your visualization, I am having only one row for Amarilla, correct? And the sale price is getting 357. It's an addition of 350 plus 7. Look, it's an addition of 350 plus 7. Similarly, the profit, 2461, sorry, the unit sold, 2966 plus 1159. These two rows for Amarilla, since I did not bring the discount band over here, they are getting summed up and it is showing me 4125. So if you multiply 4125, so what I have done, I have created a DAX. Over here I am multiplying unit sold multiplied by sale price. If you go to calculator and calculate what is 4125 multiplied by 357 and do an equals, you see you are getting a value 1472, which is not this. Okay, so what happens when I'm doing unit sold by sale price? Why am I not getting this value? Pause this video for a moment and think for yourself why this is happening. Because no matter how good I teach you or someone else teaches you, you have to learn for yourself. You have to understand the underlying data that is present in your data tab. I hope you have paused the video, resumed back. So the answer to this is, look, the SUMX will do the calculation based on the grain level of the base data. correct? That means the data which is present in your data tab. Over here, it is doing the calculation based on your discount band also, apart from segment, country and product, right? We are having two values, one for low, one for medium. Now, if you do 350 into 2966, what it does, what SUMX is doing, it is multiplying 2966 multiplied by 350. Let's say it gets the value something called A. Now it will feed that A into memory and it will hold. It will come to the second row. Again, it will do 1159 multiplied by 7. It will get a value B and it will store in its memory. Now what it will do? So it will sum up A and it plus B. So A plus B, this is the value of both these rows, right? And that value is being displayed over here. 1046, okay? So remember I had calculated a column, calculated column. Look at the values, 1038100 and 8133, which is nothing but this is my value A, this is my value B. Now it's going to add value A and value B. Sum X will add 8133 plus 1038100. If you do a equals, and now if you go to your visualization, you see 1046213. This is what SUMX does. SUMX does the calculation based on your base data that is present in your data tab. Okay, and then it will depend on what is the grain level of your visualization. You're not pulling the discount column over here. That's why it's doing a sum of those two rows, right, that is present in the base data and showing you the exact value. By the way, this is not wrong. This is correct value. Okay, for the segment, country, product and date, this is what the value is if you multiply and add those values A and B, right? Similarly, for Montana, Paseo and Velo also, you'll get the output, correct? I can prove this to you. If you also add that discount column, what will happen is you will see it will behave as if it is the base data itself. So right now, if I go to my values and I add my discount band after the product column, look, I am back. So it is again having Amarilla low and medium. Let me minimize these ones. So, okay. So for the segment Germany, Amarilla is now having two values, low and medium, right? With, look at the sale price. 296 is multiplied by 350, which is 103800. And this is 1159 multiplied by 7. So these two rows are back. Why? Because now I have brought in discount band also into the visualization. Hence, the grain is one level lower. Correct. Similarly, when I go ahead and, you know, delete both the discount band as well as the product, what happens? It gives you at the country level. For the entire country, Germany, this is what? 2212106. Look, if I do an undo, look at the value that was coming, the total for all these four product. All these four product means the upper level is Germany. For entire Germany, it is 2212106. So if you remove product, this value will be for your entire country. I hope that I have been able to make you understand the difference between SUM and SUMX. If there is something that you would like to improvise, you definitely let me know in the comments and do subscribe to my channel.